Oh, hey there, science explorers. It's Justin again. Remember the nature documentary I was watching? Well, I've been learning more about the team of scientists who created it. Did you know that they wrote a book too? And they've spoken in front of huge crowds talking about all of their research? See?
And that's when I said that we should make a nature documentary in New Jersey.
I had no idea scientists shared their ideas in so many ways. Today, we're going to explore how and why they do it. Let's get into it. Hello again. I've been doing a lot of research on the team of scientists who made that documentary because me and I want to be just like them. I've learned that they shared their findings in a lot of different ways, but I don't really know how or why they do that. But what do we know? We know that scientists take a lot of notes, right? Why do you think they might do that? Yeah, scientists use their notes to remember every little detail about their experiments and observations. Later, they look back at these notes to help them figure out what their discoveries mean and to share accurate information with other people. We'll do the same thing with our field notes. We'll take notes about our observations as we go along, and we can look back at them later when we want to remember something or learn about something even more. Scientists also use their notes to make charts and graphs like these to show what they found instead of just telling others about them. But scientists often want to get the chance to tell everyone about their discoveries, not just a few people. So, what do? Well, they write books and articles in science magazines called journals. They might also speak to large crowds about what they've discovered. And, of course, sometimes they make documentaries to show everyone what they've experienced. Like we are! All of that is really cool, and I can't wait to explore and make our own documentary to share with the world too. But it's also important to know why we're doing it. How will our discoveries and our documentary help others? Well, for us, it's pretty simple. We just want to learn more about the world around us and help others do that too. I don't think it's always that simple for other scientists, though. Why do other scientists share their work, Mia? Wow. Scientists share their work for a lot of reasons. One is to help others learn, like we want to. Sometimes scientists also share their discoveries to help make life better for people, like when they find a treatment for a disease or a way to keep the Earth cleaner. They also share their work to get even more ideas about the things they research or look for information about. Wow, I never knew there were so many reasons why scientists do the things they do. It sounds like they're always working together to discover and share new things with the world. Which reminds me, the documentary I was watching was also made by a team of scientists, not just one person. There must be some benefits to working with other people instead of just working alone. Have you ever worked with someone else to do a task or complete a project? What do you think might be a benefit of working with others? Pause here and record your ideas in your field notes. Well, just like how Mia and I share our tools and help each other, scientists share tools and resources to help each other out too. When scientists discuss their work with each other, they can solve big problems a lot faster. Sharing their ideas with each other is a way that they learn new things and come up with better ideas. Working together also helps scientists make fewer mistakes. When someone else is reading their work, they might be able to spot mistakes that were missed the first time. And teamwork can speed up discoveries. When scientists work together, they can finish big projects faster, just like how Mia and I are working together to make our documentary. Wow, science explorers, we have learned so much today about how scientists share their discoveries and why working together is so important. I think we might be ready to really go out and explore, not just my backyard, but other places in the world too. Ooh, Maybe we should head down to the park. That's still close to home, but there's so much more to see and discover there. We'll see you at the park. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers. Hey, hey.